Today we're looking at the Interact Pro control system by Signify, which works seamlessly with these Coreline luminaires by Philips.
Okay, so you had me busily going round to each of the three lighting points that we've got here, making a simple connection for line, neutral and CBC. So that must mean, Gordon, you've got all the technical stuff to look at.
Yeah, well, technical, normally when you think of lighting control systems of the past, you'd be thinking, yeah, technical, specialist wiring, commissioning visits, laptops. This system is different. It's incredibly easy to commission and incredibly easy to manage after you've commissioned it. All it needs is a mobile phone and a hub, which connects to the internet, which we've installed behind us. And then the communication between all the elements then is easy with a wireless protocol.
So we've downloaded the relevant app. Which app was that, Gordon?
So that's the Signify app. You find that in the Google Play Store or the Apple App Store. Just Interact Pro, download it. And then all we've done off camera is set up a project. So we're basically, you're going to join us when we're ready to install and commission the project.
So the app's ready and we're up and running and we're ready to go. So that must mean that we've perhaps already done all the footage people are going to see. And the reason behind that is we made a decision to work out how easy it is to commission this system. We've done it in real time, haven't we, Gordon?
We have. And so, warts and all, we've gone through the whole system start to finish. So, yeah, we'll rejoin at the end to see how we got on.
So what stage are we at now, Gordon?
Okay, so we've installed our app. We've created our project. The first stage of commissioning the project is we have to add our hub, which we've mounted on the wall here. And in this, if you bring the camera in, Gary, you'll see there's three lights, and we're normally like an LED. There's the power on, it is connected to the network, and it's connected to the cloud. So we're basically ready to go. So I'm gonna open up my app again, touch on the project. It says, well, there's nothing to control. Well, there is soon, because we're gonna add the gateway. And you basically just scan the QR code. There we go. And now we are now connecting the gateway. This may take up to 20 seconds. There we go. It's good. So now we can continue and discover the lights that we've got in the project.
So off camera, I've energized all three of my light fittings, Gordon. But unless we have a power cut, they're staying on all the time.
Okay, so it's back to the app. Now we've got to add and discover what's in the project. So miraculously, the app says, discover lights. It says this process may take some minutes.
Right,
so
let's
push the button, start discovering.
Right, okay, so we're off and ready. So we've got a little countdown clock there to start the discovery process. Uh-huh. And this is what, finding the lights we've got in the system?
It is, finding the lights we've got in the system. It says this can take up to 20 minutes, so right. We may have to rejoin you later with this.
Okay, so how is it finding these lights then, Gordon?
So these are communicating with a Zigbee-based protocol. So I guess at the moment the hub behind us is searching out various, to find out what Zigbee products are transmitting or discoverable on a network. So, okay, so it's now discovered three, and okay. We have three. So I'm gonna try and just press the stop discovering.
Okay,
and now it's fetching data, so it says this can take up to 10 minutes.
We've only got three. Because yeah. How many light fittings, just remind me again, how many light fittings could we have on this system?
The hub itself will support up to 200 light fittings and 50 input devices, of which 30 of those can be occupancy absence detection sensors.
All right, hence the amount of time that it suggests it could take.
Yeah, so okay. we're fetching data now, so I guess it's
33. I think almost that was quick. We've only got three, but that was quick.
That was quick. So now it says create groups. So I'm assuming groups means essentially rooms that we're thinking. So I'm now going to create a group.
Okay, so back into the app.
So let's create a new group. Let's call that Gary's Bench.
Okay, so Gary's Bench.
So I'm going to create that. Gary's Bench. And
so we're going through this process trying to find these lights. We're now pairing them or grouping them. So you're in that process.
Yeah, so three, it says on the top of the app here, we've got three. One gateway, three lights unassigned.
Right, so you can assign one at a time.
Yeah, so there's an unknown. So you can see here, I've got the Coreline down light.
Point that one out. This is the Coreline down light just here.
Well done.
Okay.
Got a Coreline panel.
Coreline panel.
And we've got, it says unknown, but I'm guessing this behind us is that, so.
It'd be quite remarkable if one of the lights above our head came on, wouldn't it?
It would.
Here we go.
So I'm going to assign the lights.
Okay, so assigning the lights.
I'm going to assign it to Gary's Bench.
So what's really nice is we're doing this first time out of the packet, aren't we?
We've never
played with this before. So you're bearing with us. This is trying to show you in real time how to discover and use the app. So we've not been away practicing this, you know, for all morning, so it looks super slick. We want to feel the pinch points that the electrician would feel at the same time and how intuitive it is. And it seems quite intuitive at the minute.
Since that was easy, I'm going to create another group.
Two groups. So you've got a light in a group at the moment.
And we're going to call that Gordon's Wall.
Gordon's Wall. So I hope that's the one behind us, or we'll have some fun seeing it isn't. Okay, so called that one. Right, so there's another group created.
And we're gonna, there's one light on a sign, so okay. That one there.
So you're going to assign hopefully the one that's not, yeah, behind us.
Light. Put that on as well. Right. Sign.
So you've now got two lights assigned to me on the bench, one signed to you behind. I don't know that. Are you going to do something to prove that they're assigned?
Okay, so that was easy, Gary, on a small project, but obviously on a larger project, you'd probably have to walk around different rooms to find out where these fittings that have been discovered actually are. You'd have to physically discover them yourself. So to do that on the app, again, just tap on the room we've just done, and I'll just tap on the light in question. So unknown two is behind. No, Gary, it's behind you.
Oh, that's flashing here. Sorry, I apologize. I see the light flashing down there. Okay. I've discovered it, I would suggest, at that stage. So is that in your...
That's Gordon's Wall.
Gordon's Wall, and it's flashing.
So I'll repeat the process, Gary. Yeah, look behind you.
Yeah. Which one's going to flash, Gordon?
It's in front of you. So, okay, so there's the LED panel.
Right, okay.
And there's the down light.
Right, so that's brilliant. So you can confirm which area you've put them in, or you're hunting down a fitting, etc. When you found maybe you've got 100 fittings, it's going to be obviously very needed at that stage.
Yeah, I could have done that as I walked around, and then as I found them, assigned them to the rooms that I've created.
So
that was fun. So now let's add some controls. So at the minute it says there's no controls assigned.
Okay, so we're going to have to unplug the electricity, turn the lights off.
I'm going to try and add a switch, Gary.
Add a switch.
Now, normally, you'd be out grabbing your ladders, pulling in cables. Yeah, you've found the switch.
Well, I don't stop you there, Gordon. Just want to panic you a little bit here. I can't see any cables. And there are no batteries, so what does this work on?
So these are kinetic based switches, so they're harvesting the energy when you push the switch itself.
Work on magic.
So I'm going to now, in the app, add a switch.
So just bring in a little bit closer camera here to have a look.
So we've got a two-button switch here, select that. So it says first instruction, remove the flip from the rocker case.
Right, so this is going to pair the switch.
Switch to the hub and establish it on the network, discover it.
Okay.
So I've got to have that the right way around, looking for a little zero at the top.
Okay.
So I'm going to hold that down and press the activator for 10 seconds.
All right, okay, you count to 10. So this is the first part of the pairing process. So we're going to pair one switch to my lights on the bench. Do you think we'll do yours as well, Gordon?
We can have another go at that, yeah. Well, let's just see how lucky we are with this first attempt.
Okay, so that's for 10 seconds.
And release that.
What's it? Another instruction now.
Drum roll.
Instruction.
Then I have to press 1 and 2 at the same time and button 3 to confirm. So I'll do that.
All right, okay, so you're pressing top confirmed. Right, bottom left.
Yep, give the switch a name, so I'll call this Gary's Switch. It's original.
Right, okay, I like that.
Gary's Switch, so I've done. So I've done that, now I have to assign the switch to a group, so I suggest we'll put that with Gary's bench, unless you want to control my lights.
No, not really.
So I'll sign that there while that's updating itself.
Rebuild it back together.
Rebuild the switch.
That didn't seem very long, Gordon, in order to pair that one. Will it work?
Yeah,
and you've got to put it back together. So, okay, then. Flip it in then.
I'll put that in there. Oh, there we go. Lights on.
Okay. Press and hold. Oh, down it goes. So get it around the right way. It's still got a polarity, Gordon, so we've got on and off.
Some parts of the world, they have that different way.
Well, can I have a go? So are we saying down's on or up's on at the moment? So all we need to do is turn it round, and that will be coming on. I like that.
Yeah.
And off.
So I think I'll add another switch.
Are you going to add another switch to this lighting arrangement, or the one behind us?
I think it's about time I had my own switch, Gary.
So you can have a Gordon switch now,
yeah,
are we?
Yeah, so I'm going to...
add switch, two okay. button switch.
So while he's doing that, I really like this system from the point of view the electrician only needs to take round a line, a neutral and a CPC to all the lighting points, and then the controls added afterwards. So it gives you massive flexibility. Got a really large office, he was here and counting to 10. Got a really large office and you wanted to put some switches in place, and then all of a sudden you reconfigure it, obviously maybe divide it in the middle, and all of a sudden you're thinking, ah, all the lights come on from one switch in both offices now. No, just reassign the lights to new switches, and obviously you're off and running. You've done it already?
I'm confirmed, so I'm going to call it.
Just already naming your switch.
Switch. Okay. Done. And I'm going to assign that to a group, so that's assign that to Gordon's wall. Okay. Assign. Assign it to group.
Oh, yeah, right, okay. So that should be up and running straight away, yeah?
So
rebuild your switch.
I'll rebuild it.
And we're expecting the one behind us now to be operated from that switch. And that's how simple it was. So if you were changing an office round, simply reassign switches and light fittings to each area.
Oh, there we go.
Easy.
Marvellous.
And remember, we're doing this in real time. This is the amount of time it's taken me and Gordon to understand what we've got to do and actually pair them in. So well done, Gordon. That was really quick.
Yeah. Well, that switch is off.
Okay, yeah.
Switch on, or okay. I can hold, and I should be able to dim this down very
okay,
well.
Okay, let's see if it dims. Oh yeah, there it goes.
Dimming down.
I like that.
There. I can go a little bit further.
Here we go. Brilliant. So that's a switch and a dimmer.
Switch and a dimmer, yeah.
Okay, that's really clever.
I mean, we can touch on scene setting. That's probably something for the future. So you can obviously have multiple scenes and different lights doing different things in the office. A key thing to remember about these fittings is that the control system is built into the fitting. It's not like a lot of other systems out there. There's a lot of wireless systems out there which rely on you sort of interfering with the wiring to the fixture itself. Perhaps tapping at the Darley ballast and things like that. This is incredibly simple. Out the box, they work, and then you can bring in that functionality. You can also add in an occupancy sensor.
Okay.
And guess how long it lasts on the battery, Gary?
So these are battery powered.
Battery powered, so completely wireless. One AA battery in there.
Okay, a year.
8 years.
Wow, 8 years. So that's manual switches, that's an occupancy sensor, and I think we've got occupancy video.
We've got a video if you don't, do occupancy or absence. Okay. So if you haven't seen that, check out that video. You can also control them with the phone app as well.
Oh, right,
so
okay.
So you can give users the ability to control the light in their space.
Oh, that's really key, isn't it, in their space. You wouldn't want them maybe sitting in their office turning the lights on and off downstairs.
I want you controlling Gordon's wall with Gary's switch. Okay. That just wouldn't be on.
What else do you want to cover while we're in there?
Okay, so the only thing to think about is this system is incredibly powerful. We've showed a simple switching setup here. You can use the app to remotely monitor things like energy and make adjustments to the system completely remotely from site.
Okay.
Via the hub. Now, I think we need to try that. So I think we'll do a little follow-up video and we'll go off-site and see if we can control these lights from the eFIXX customer service center.
With following that on, could you maybe do some fault diagnosis that way as well?
Well, let's find out.
Okay, so we'll find that out in another video. As always, eFIXX are interested in your comments. Have you fitted this lighting control system before? Are you thinking about fitting one in the future? What control systems do you like using at the moment? And me and the team at eFIXX will get back to as many of the comments as we can.